spirit in the world of cricket. A merry prankster in the gentleman's game. Cannonball blazing through the best bowling in the world. A man with no regard for history or reputation. A batsman with a style all his own. A warrior and a gambler who conquers with brute force and sheer audacity. A small man, but a big scoring giant without compare. Virender Sehwag on the Golden Generation. Sehwag just doesn't care. He is unburdened by worries about field placements, the state of the game, the quality of the bowler, the score he is on.
Sehwag, he loves to go hard.
Multan 2004, Sehwag is on 295. And this is how he brings up the first ever triple century by an Indian.
Up, up, there it is! Huge six, 300. And can you believe it? He got a 100 with a six. He ramped it over third man. He made his mind up. The audacity to think about just launching one over deep mid on.
He's a very serious cricketer. And his philosophy is to score runs.
I think he has the potential to be anything that he wants to be. He has that much talent and ability.
The road that led Sehwag to this incredible feat in Multan began in the unlikeliest of places, on the dusty streets of Najafgarh, a poor Delhi suburb. Born into a house with siblings, uncles, aunts and 16 cousins, cricket belonged to a different world for the struggling family. Yet the game flowed in Sehwag's blood.
जब मैं बड़ा हो रहा था, तो मैं क्रिकेट के पीछे पागल था और कह सकते हैं कि एक पैशन था कि सुबह जाता था, शाम को आता था, घर वाले परेशान रहते थे कि ये कहाँ जाता है, क्या करता है, कब आता है, तो उनको क्योंकि मेरे घर में कोई क्रिकेट खेला नहीं, किसी को क्रिकेट की नॉलेज नहीं, किसी को पता भी नहीं था कि क्रिकेट होता क्या
है। Sehwag was lucky his father, a grain hawker, could afford to pay for his cricket training and did so despite being skeptical that any good will come out of it. But in these harsh conditions, a remarkable player was being fashioned.
इसका एक एटीट्यूड था अटैक करना। बचपन से जब ये स्कूल में था, तब मैंने कभी इसको ये नहीं मना किया कि तुम मत मारो। मैंने कहा अगर आप मार सकते हो, बॉल को हिट कर सकते हो, तो go and hit. What is the harm in it? Ball is meant to hit.
Sehwag's coaches knew that he had to get to Delhi to have any chance of showing his talent, so he was admitted to a Delhi school. His first steps in the big city.
नजफगढ़ से बाहर नहीं गया, क्योंकि हम लोग प्रैक्टिस सीमेंट और मैटिंग पे करते थे और जब मैचेस खेलते थे वो नेचुरल टर्फ पे खेलते थे। तो वहाँ से वो मुझे लेके गए मिस्टर एन शर्मा के पास और वहाँ से मेरी एक्चुअली जो कहते हैं कि क्रिकेट स्टार्ट हुई।
वंस इन द सिटी, सेहवाग्स फैंटास्टिक टैलेंट शोन थ्रू, बट शीयर टैलेंट इज नेवर इनफ एंड द पॉलिटिक्स ऑफ वन ऑफ द कंट्रीज वर्स्ट रन स्टेट बोर्ड वाज वेइंग हिम डाउन।
कि मैं जाता था नजफगढ़ से फिरोजशाह जो कि लगभग 45 किलोमीटर मेरे घर से, और वहाँ पर हमें सुबह 8 बजे पहुँचना होता था ट्रायल्स के लिए, और मैं 8 बजे का मतलब है मुझे 5:30 बजे की बस पकड़नी पड़ती थी। बस का नंबर था 783 शहीद भगत सिंह टर्मिनल, और वो बस पकड़ने के लिए मुझे सुबह उठना पड़ता था लगभग 4:30 बजे। और जब मुझे वहाँ पिक नहीं किया गया, मुझे सिर्फ नेट में 6 बॉलें खेलने को मिली, 6 बॉलें खेलने के बाद मुझे निकाल दिया गया।
But Sehwag bounced back quickly, scoring 100 in the club match to get picked for the Delhi Under-19 state team.
When he started playing, I was umpiring. When he started really scoring runs heavily in local cricket, I was umpiring, and you know it was a joy to watch him because that carefree attitude. I think he's taken it to international level as well.
Just like his batting, once Sehwag got the momentum, he never looked back. He was uninhibited and brutal in his attack. And the domestic circuit had a man to fear.
We were playing against West Zone at Mohali. I was batting with him. He came in, say, 5 or 6 in the batting order. And the talk was that let's avoid the follow-on. But this guy had different plans altogether. Once I got out, the score was 100 for 5 or something. And then he went berserk. They had Zaheer Khan, Ajit Aggarkar in that attack. and he just tore them apart.
If it is his day, and if his eyes are really working well with his legs and arms, there's nothing much a bowler could do. And even I could be belted all over the park. So he really instills fear in the minds of the bowler.
A furious primal talent like Sehwag didn't take much time to catch the eye of the national selectors. But no one knew quite what to make of him. Was he just a slog hitter with no real pedigree? He was picked as a bits and pieces man for an ODI series against Pakistan in 1999, but didn't make an impact.
So, पहली बार मैं इतना fast bowler खेल रहा था शोएब अख्तर को क्योंकि उससे पहले domestic में कभी खेला नहीं था मैं fast bowler. तो सब कुछ इतनी जल्द हुआ कि realize नहीं हुआ कि क्या करना चाहिए. लेकिन उसके बाद 99 के बाद जब मैं drop हुआ तो मुझे realize हुआ कि हाँ अगर मुझे international cricket खेलनी है तो मुझे अपनी batting और improve करनी पड़ेगी fast bowling के लिए. तब मैं नंबर 6 से शायद नंबर 4 और नंबर 3 पर बैटिंग करना शुरू हुआ.
Sheer hard work had lifted Sehwag from obscurity to the highest level of cricket, and he turned to that discipline again to get back in form. When he was picked again, this time in the test team to tour South Africa, he was ready.
On the back foot, just a push, just a hint.
He came in with India reeling at 68 for 4 and blasted his way to a century on debut.
What a shot. Now this has become a modern day innovation. Terrific shot.
Getting runs is not about technique. Getting runs is all about your attitude and your mindset. And I think in that perspective, Sehwag is a very smart cricketer. He's a very calculative cricketer.
The signs were there to see, but who could predict just how much this short, soft-spoken man, a self-confessed Tendulkar clone, would change the definition of batting.
मैं कह सकता हूँ कि मैंने क्रिकेट अगर सीखी या खेलना शुरू किया तो वो सिर्फ टेंडुलकर की वजह से. मैं सिर्फ टेंडुलकर की बैटिंग देखना चाहता था और जब वो जैसा वो टीवी में खेलते मुझे नजर आते थे मैं वैसी शेडो प्रैक्टिस टीवी के बाहर करता था मैच देखते हुए कि मैं भी ऐसा खेलूं मैं भी ऐसा दिखूं.
The comparisons were inevitable. On the pitch, it was sometimes difficult to distinguish between Sehwag and Sachin, both stocky and diminutive, both big shot stroke makers, the master and the new sensation, a terrible twosome for bowlers.
With the uppercut.
He's played pretty well.
मेरे लिए एक honour की बात होगी कि जिसको मैंने देखकर क्रिकेट सीखी उसी के साथ मेरा नाम जोड़ दिया गया या मुझे compare कर दिया गया. जबकि आप देखें तो मैं तो उनके सामने एक चिटी के बराबर भी नहीं.
Despite his humility, Sehwag equals Tendulkar in the ease with which he smashes bowlers all around the ground and leaves the master far behind when it comes to sheer bravado.
Down the wicket he goes again, inside out he goes. This is going to be caught. No, he's not. It's six again. He timed that absolutely magnificently.
In 2002, India's then captain Sourav Ganguly latched onto this daring attitude and asked him to open the batting in tests. Sehwag was not so sure.
I felt that he was too good a player to sit out, and I had simple logic that if you're good enough, you can play the new ball.
मेरे दिमाग में एक ही ख्याल आया कि आप लोग भी तो opening करते हो वनडे में. इतने सालों से आप लोग opening करते रहे तो आपने क्यों नहीं की test matches में opening? तो मुझे वहाँ ख्याल आया कि शायद टेस्ट क्रिकेट में ओपनिंग बहुत टफ जॉब है. तो वो एक डाउट उस समय आया. लेकिन जब मैंने उनसे पूछा कि अगर मुझे वापस मिडिल ऑर्डर में जगह मिलेगी खेलने के लिए तब मैं कर सकता हूँ, तो उन्होंने कॉन्फिडेंस दिया, हाँ हम आपको वापस मिडिल ऑर्डर में खिलाएंगे अगर आपको सक्सेस नहीं मिली एज ओपनर. उसके बाद मुझे कभी डाउट नहीं हुआ कि मैं रन बना सकता हूँ या नहीं बना सकता.
He proved a perfect fit from his first match as opener, smashing 80 runs and then followed it up with 100 in the next. A few months later, he notched up his first double 100. His cavalier starts were giving India the platform to deliver historic wins.
He can win you games, he can change games on his own. So that is what makes him so special. Like, there'll be times where he'll get out in the first over, maybe on a low score, but at the same time, he can set you games where you can just go out there and play a normal game.
Oh, that's another sizzling shot. But the questions remained. His radically innovative style of batting was exciting, but not reassuring.
Edge and drop.
His disdain for good bowling thrilling, but dangerous. Will he survive in international cricket? That test came in 2003, India's tour to Australia.
The challenge is on. Virender Sehwag with a little smile.
On the first day of the Boxing Day test, Sehwag was on fire.
It was in the air, but was travelling like a bullet.
Driving and cutting the fast bowlers, lofting the spinners out of the ground.
Whack.
It was sheer brilliance.
Yeah, that's the way that Sehwag plays.
And the verdict was loud and clear. Here was an all-time great in the making.
Sehwag, imperious. Fifth test match under for Virender Sehwag.
Well, there was a different approach in that particular game because there was dampness. He actually changed his game plan for a while before actually going back to plan A, which was again that doing what he does best. And the results are there for everyone to see. 195 in one day, getting out to a full toss in the end, where he could have easily scored a double century, but that's what Sehwag is.
Should be four, that's gone like lightning. In March 2004, Team India stepped into Pakistan to play a test series after a gap of 15 years. A historic moment, no doubt, but Sehwag wanted to make it his own.
Beautifully played, nicely balanced.
On a peaceful day in Multan, in an almost empty stadium, Sehwag unleashed a spectacular attack, an artillery barrage of epic proportions, to score the first ever triple century by an Indian.
Can you believe it? He got the audacity, a brilliant 300.
मैंने सोचा नहीं था कि मैं triple century बना सकता हूँ test cricket में, लेकिन वो सब कहते हैं कि भगवान ने आपकी किस्मत में लिखा था कि आप triple century बनाओगे, और आपने triple century बना दी. तो अगर आप मुझसे दोबारा पूछें कि आपने कैसे बना दी, क्या हुआ, तो मैं आपको कोई एक्सप्लेनेशन नहीं दे सकता, क्योंकि उस समय मैं सिर्फ बॉल देख रहा था, शॉट खेल रहा था, क्योंकि ये सोच के खेल ही नहीं रहा था कि जब मैं 200 के पास था तब मैंने सोचा था कि हाँ, मैंने वही गलती नहीं दोहरानी जो मैंने मेलबर्न में दोहराई थी जिससे कि हम लोग मैच हार गए.
Sehwag continued in breathless fashion, hitting centuries in tests faster than most people score in ODIs, scoring hundreds on pitches where the rest of the Indian team failed.
Should go into the boundary.
Scattering bowlers like he was practicing in the nets.
I think just in terms of how decisive he is, how he shapes matches and how he's able to just scatter the opposition, their feels, their thinking, their sanity, really, because when you have somebody like Sehwag going on, so nothing makes sense. You just feel so helpless.
Virender Sehwag departing.
Those who live by the sword, it is said, die by it. After the glorious peaks, the dashing opener was brought down to earth. A string of one-day failures where he threw away his wicket, and the doubts about his technique and temperament were again in the forefront. But the Indian team had the courage and patience to back him.
I'll ask you one question. Do you think Sehwag can win a World Cup final? And I think he can. So, Viru at times can be frustrating. I've explained that situation in one of those situations pretty clearly in the book, but it's what he gives you too. And you need players like that.
Sehwag has timed it very well indeed.
Though Sehwag continued to light up the test arena, making huge scores at breathtaking speed, a brilliant 254 against Sri Lanka, tantalizingly close to a century before lunch on day one of the St. Lucia test against West Indies, a feat no Indian batsman has ever managed. Yet his one-day form kept dipping.
Oh, that's out! That's RBW Shaw! Yes, up goes the finger! That was absolutely spot on!
His fitness levels too were under the scanner, and Team India were involved in an ugly battle with their coach Greg Chappell. In 2007, after India's shock exit from the World Cup, the axe dropped on Sehwag. Once named as India's future captain, he now had no role to play in the Indian team.
Dravid fought and fought and fought to keep Sehwag in the team for as long as he could. Because his thinking was that Chappell has not seen what Sehwag can actually do, the kind of impact he can have, the kind of impact player that he is. Whereas Chappell was coming from a school where he wanted yes men, essentially, who said your ideas are terrific and if he said jump, they said how high. And Sehwag was never going to do that. And he wasn't informed, which was actually went against him. Maybe at that period of time, he should have been dropped much earlier than he eventually was.
Life had come full circle for the Nawab of Najafgarh. He was back in the domestic circuit, once again trying to prove himself. But by now, everyone knew that Sehwag had only one way to go, up.
मुझे याद है जब 300 बनाया तो शायद 300-400 एसएस मैसेज आए थे मेरे फ्रेंड्स और सबके मीडिया की तरफ से, लेकिन जब ड्रॉप हुआ तो मुझे याद है कि गिने चुने शायद 30 मैसेज भी नहीं होंगे मेरे पास कि जिन्होंने मुझे कहा होगा कि कोई बात नहीं है रो। इवन इंडियन टीम से भी शायद 2 या 3 ही प्लेयर थे जिन्होंने मुझे एसएमएस किए।
A heavy loss of form dropped from both the ODI and the test squad, yet there was light at the end of the tunnel. Though he wasn't in the list of probables for India's tour to Australia in late 2007, Team India took a gamble with the gambler. Sehwag was picked with immediate results. He provided the blazing momentum for a historic win at Perth and then smashed 151 in Adelaide.
And into the boundary. Again 150 for Virender Sehwag. Even the Australians will clap now.
मुझे अनिल कुंबले का आज भी वो वर्ड याद है कि अनिल कुंबले मुझे फ़ोन किया था कि वीरू यू आर टू गुड टू सेट आउट, बट कभी कभी सर्कमस्टांसिस ऐसे आ जाते हैं कि अच्छे प्लेयर को भी बाहर बैठना पड़ जाता है, बट आप हार्डवर्क करते रहना और मैं आपको प्रॉमिस करता हूँ कि आप ज़रूर कम बैक करोगे। और जब वो कैप्टन बने तो उन्होंने मुझे ऑस्ट्रेलिया के पिक किया, थैंक्स टू अनिल कुंबले कि उनकी वजह से मेरी कमबैक हुई।
दो ही वाज स्टिल स्ट्रगलिंग इन ओडीआईज, यू वुडंट नो वाचिंग दिस इनिंग्स ऑफ प्योर ब्रिलियंस, द फर्स्ट टेस्ट अगेंस्ट साउथ अफ्रीका इन चेन्नई एंड सेहवाग लुक्ड लाइक ही वाज बैटिंग अगेंस्ट अ हाई स्कूल टीम।
आई थिंक इट्स गॉन ऑल द वे फॉर 6, व्हाट अ शॉट।
ही टुक एन इनक्रेडिबल 278 बॉल्स टू गेट टू हिज सेकंड टेस्ट 300 and became only the third batsman to get 2 triple centuries after Sir Don Bradman and Brian Lara.
The big wagon wheel celebration.
मुझे मालूम है कि जब मैं 100 बनाता हूँ उसके बाद जब मैं अगले 100 या 50 जो भी बनाऊंगा वो इतने जल्दी बनेंगे जिससे कि टीम को बेनिफिट मिलेगा और हम लोग मैच जीतने की पोजीशन में आ जाएंगे। तो जब मैं 100 बनाता हूँ उसके बाद मैं सेटिस्फाई नहीं होता क्योंकि मुझे मालूम है कि जब मैं 100 बनाऊंगा तो मेरे शायद अगले 2 या 3 इनिंग में मैं रन भी नहीं बनाऊंगा, तो मैं कोशिश करता हूं उन 2 इनिंगों को भी मैं कवर कर दूं इस इनिंग में।
In July 2008, Sehwag produced another gem, and this time a side of Sehwag no one knew existed came into play. While the famed Indian batting lineup reeled against the venom of Murali and Mendis, Sehwag dug deep and compiled a patient double century, taking India yet again on the path to victory.
Destructive innings and one of the very best you would have seen from anyone at this level.
गोल में जब इनिंग स्टार्ट की तो मेरे लिए चैलेंज था, तो मैं हर बॉल पर अपने आप को बोल रहा था कि दुनिया में कहीं भी 100 बना सकते हो, लेकिन श्रीलंका में इन 2 स्पिनर कहेंगे 100 बनाओ तब तुम्हारी वैल्यू पता चलेगी। तो उसमें मैंने 100 बनाया, तो 100 के बाद मैंने फिर ये कहना स्टार्ट किया 100 तो बना सकते हो लेकिन इस 100 को 150 में कन्वर्ट करो। तो 150 हुआ तो मैंने उसको बोला कि इसको 100 बना के दिखाओ, अगर तुम्हारी टीम हार रही है, मतलब विकेट गिर रहे हैं, बड़ा स्कोर नहीं बना पा रहे, तो तुम डबल बनाओगे तो शायद 300 समथिंग रन बनाए।
By the end of the year, Sehwag had scored 1150 plus scores on the trot in Test cricket, an incredible and unmatched feat. Sehwag, it seemed, was delivering as promised.
Oh, he goes for that. He was waiting for it.
Paddy Upton ने हमसे पूछा था एक सवाल कि आप कैसा चाहते हो कि आपका 2008 जाए? तब मैंने एक छोटा सा नोट लिखा था कि मैं चाहता हूँ कि मैं इंडिया का हाईएस्ट रन गेटर हूँ, और वो मैंने उन्हें लिख के दे दिया था, वो बात कॉन्फिडेंशियल थी। और जब मैं सीज़न में मैच ख़त्म हुआ तो मुझे खुद नहीं रियलाइज़ हुआ कि मैंने सबसे ज़्यादा रन बनाए, तब उन्होंने मुझे वो वापस चिट्ठी दी जी आपने जो कहा था आपने वो कर दिया।
Just went like a rocket. The man at short point had absolutely no chance.
He was also cementing his place in the one-day squad, forming a deadly opening partnership with another Delhi boy, Gautam Gambhir.
The most comfortable man in the team, if I have to be with, no doubt, Virender Sehwag. The amount of time I spent with him, even off the field, I think that makes him very special. And I think he's the only one in the team who can just walk up to me and tell me anything and everything. He can scold me if I play a bad shot, and he's got all the right to do that.
What path will Sehwag walk now? A man who has the potential to break every batting record in the books, against whom strategies fail and bowlers are clueless. What is the method to his madness?
Sehwag is one of the most selfless cricketer I have ever witnessed in my life. A batsman who plays only for the team. A batsman who wants to score runs because he wants to enjoy scoring runs.
When Viv Richards walked into bat, I think the bowlers shuddered. And I think that's probably one thing which is very common with Viru, because if you don't stop him early, you're going to be hurt the whole day.
Always enthralling, always entertaining, often frustrating, Sehwag is an enigma. A man of clay who bats like a king. A man who has reduced batting to its simplest principle, scoring runs, and turned it into an empire. Will he find the strength and patience to keep it together?
Give Sehwag 5 years more of the way he's batting. Maybe we might have to revise who's the greatest cricketer India or the world has seen.
Sehwag will probably be the leader of the next generation of the Indian team. Who, whatever it is, whatever shape it takes, he'll be, for good or for bad, and we all hope that it's for good. He'll be the one who'll help it take shape.
At 30, Sehwag is at the crossroads of his career. True greatness awaits him if he can find it. And Indian cricket needs him as much as he needs it.